terrific atmosphere for this matchup. Hi, everyone, along with Eddie Olczyk, Ray Ferraro in a moment. I'm Mike Emmerich. We feel the buzz inside the arena. We can cut the atmosphere seemingly with a knife. But I wonder, does that affect the players at all?
It does affect the players, Doc. They know it's a big game. First off, because you're here, because everybody knows it is a big game. But there is that time in a season or a particular point where, you know what, you need that energy from your crowd. And certainly you could feel it walking into the building, and certainly it's carried over into the arena tonight.
Sudbury's fan base knows how important they are to their team's success. And I know as a former player, it's something you can really feel from ice level when the crowd gets really loud. They are so close, and it almost feels like they're right on top of you. And that's what makes this building and this game so much fun to be a part of.
Okay, so let's look at the starting goaltenders for the game. This man's in the goal crease tonight. He is always acrobatic. We can expect more of that tonight for the home team. This man's the goalkeeper tonight. The book on him is that he can be rattled with an early goal. Let's see how he does tonight for the visitors. We have just begun. With Eddie Olczyk and Ray Ferraro, I'm Mike Emmerich. And it's driven away again. Wonderful save. What a skill level there.
You talk about cutting down the angle. Perfectly executed by the goaltender.
On to Lemieux. Oh, an error on that pass. Good chance here. Sudbury's got possession in the defensive zone. Takes that pass that was just slipped ahead to him. Good use of the stick, broke that pass up. Full steam up the wing. Oh, and here's a 3-on-2. Laid on to Lemieux. Oh, and the pass just didn't work. Moving it to Murphy. The Wolves control the play in their own end. Slid to Murphy. Gets by. Oh, that's good. Perfect centering pass. Score! Didn't take long, did it? Sudbury's ahead by one goal here in the first period. A lot of time still left to play, but getting one and breaking the tie was huge. Niagara's got another faceoff win. Out in front. That hit somebody.
Time of the goal. 4 minutes, 11 seconds.
Got that pass near the blue line and now looks ahead. The Ice Dogs carrying on in their own end. Pass to the slot. Heads on to the corner. Shoots. Wide. What a chance.
What an outstanding look, but he just missed the net.
Niagara is only going to get 2 minutes on this call, but it was tripping.
This is an easy call for the official, Doc. Player made no attempt to play the puck and just tripped up the attacking player.
The Wolves get their first power play of the game. Big faceoff win. Drives to the net. Fires. Save. Let it lay there, but he got the whistle and stoppage of play.
I don't know how the shooter can do much more than that. The goaltender made an excellent save on a great bit for goal.
Just over 6 minutes played in the first. Only one goal hanging on the board so far. So it's 1-0. Face-off win here. Great job on a cut pass. And this one is feathered back away by Lemieux. They must retreat and start back again. Wolves through the neutral zone have control. Nicely received at the point. Accidentally blocked. Goalies will take that one. Sends it back the other way. Nice play with the stick. Nothing more will come. Possession seized by Lemieux. On through the corner. Oh,
know, a lot of people have been critical of no-touch icing because it takes some of the energy out of the race for the puck. But we've just seen one there. Didn't seem to be any harm. Good face-off win. Blue line control. Perfect receipt of the pass. Save! He covers, and a face-off will follow.
Well, the shooter's pretty disappointed, guys. He delivered that puck quickly. It was accurate, yet the goaltender was just better than him on the wrist shot.
Good job tying the man up on the faceoff. Teammate comes in.
The Wolves, through the neutral zone, lug the puck.
Cleared back along and out of harm's way. Looks ahead to start something. The Ice Dogs, with a big penalty kill, were back at full strength. Blocked with the pad. Taken to the slot. Blocked away. It's one of those restraining fouls. It's a hooking penalty, and the arm of the referee is up. And we get another penalty. The referee goes to the penalty timekeeper.
This was okay about 10 years ago. Not anymore. That's a hooking call.
Every game presents a fork in the road opportunity, and this is it. It's a long 5-on-3 power play, and it begins now. Sudbury's quick on the draw. Fires! He missed the net with the shot.
He was trying to be a little bit too fine there. That's why he missed the net.
Offside stops the clock. Sudbury's got that one. Now what? Outstanding play.
The Wolves lug the puck in their own end. To Murphy.
Sliced through the neutral zone. Got it at the point. Niagara survived it. Back even. The Ice Dogs
lug the puck in the defensive zone.
Nice move to shake on through. Missed the net! Lemieux hooked on this play, and the arm of the referee is high. The Wolves are given a hooking minor.
Oh, this is not a good penalty. A lazy penalty behind the play, reaching in, turning the stick over, and hooking the player.
And so begins power play number one. Let's see if it's power play goal number one. Sudbury's prevailed on another faceoff. Great job stopping and holding. Oh, he missed the net.
I know what he's trying to do there, Doc, but you got to hit the net in this situation.
Block that one. A terrific clear. Took that pass perfectly off the wing. And that one's fired back down the ice, and there will be no need for a touch-up on this. Icing is called by the linesman.
The shooter thought he'd made a pretty good shot here, but the goaltender's in good shape. He makes the stop, and he's able to deny the shooter on what he thought was an excellent chance.
The Ice Dogs with a face-off win. Niagara setting things up through the neutral zone. Goes right through him. Must get it out. Two sticks together, it goes to the offense.
The Wolves in their own end in possession as they travel.
Forcing attention in deep. Takes that pass. The pass is off the mark. What a chance that would have been. Terrific interception. The Ice Dogs
have it in their own end.
Takes that cross-ice pass from his left and is able to march on. Caromed off the mask.
That's what we call a purpose shot. The Wolves are not concerned about their goaltending. a couple of real good stops, but none better than that. What a save early in this game.
Sudbury's got a defensive zone win. He knifed it away. He's got that point pass. In the slot, he's got it.
The Wolves have killed it all.
Picks it up in his own end. Moves to the corner. The stick can break up a play, and it just did.
Those big pillows on his legs came in handy then.
The Wolves continue on through the neutral zone. Moved along and in. Knocks it away with the stick. Oh, deflected away. Niagara's in control of the puck in the defensive zone. Can he generate something? Ooh, that one accidentally blocked. Great save, point blank.
You want to score goals, you have to go to this area.
Nice fake, shakes him loose.
The Ice Dogs organizing back in their own end.
Right in front. He could start some danger here. Got that pass in the corner. One timer. Oh, and it's off the mark.
You have to give yourself a chance here. You cannot blow this puck past the net.
Good quick poke check there. Not a long pass, but effective. He's got it. The clock has bled down to the last minute.
1 minute left.
Speeds right on goal. Niagara's in possession as they travel through center. In the slot. Wonderful save with a pad.
I don't know how much of this puck he stopped, guys, but it was just enough to keep it out of the net.
The Ice Dogs prevailed again. Wrist shot, deflected off the blocker. A cover, and play is stopped.
You can't ask much more from your goaltender than this. That's an excellent wrist shot that he's able to deny.
Good job on the draw.
The Wolves in their own end in possession.
We have one period in the books. It's a 1-0 game.
Just a friendly reminder about tonight's silent auction. All items can be viewed and bid upon at the display near the guest services counter.
The Wolves have a lead. It is just one, and they did it this way. We'll be right back. Second period about to begin here. Let's take a look back at the first. What impressed you most?
The Ice Dogs are down in this game, Doc, and rightfully so. They did not manage the puck at all. If they want to get back in that game, they got to eliminate those turnovers.
First faceoff of period two.
The Wolves have control of the puck at center ice.
Pointed
to Murphy.
Oh, wonderful play. Niagara's carrying on at center ice. Back in his defensive end to get it. It's an odd man rush. It's a 3-on-2. And that shot missed.
Right idea, but he just missed the net.
Back in front. Lets it fly. Wide of the net.
The Wolves have control of the puck in the defensive zone.
Nice poke check.
By Lemieux.
Looks ahead to start something.
The Wolves with possession in center ice. Making progress through the neutral zone.
Right in front, hit by the stick. That's just good fundamental defense. A little over 4 minutes played. The Wolves lead 1-0. Sudbury's got a face-off win. Got that pass up the same side of the ice. Good work, stepped on by. The Ice Dogs have it in the defensive zone. Good hand to eye, and the reach of the stick. He's held to the glass. He's got a great kick pass. At the point, big shot! And he'll curl back and look for help. There's a hooking call on this play, but he keeps going. Play is stopped. There is a signal. We just wanted to see who it is he's taking off. Sudbury's two-minute penalty is a minor, and the call is hooking.
The referees are looking for this. Anytime you stop skating and reach with your stick and pull on the opponent, you're going to the penalty box.
Niagara's power play gets another chance to operate. Hasn't been effective yet.
Sudbury penalty.
The Ice Dogs prevailing on the faceoff.
Time of the penalty. 6 minutes.
Right there, but can he get it out of harm's way? Cleared out, and that forces them to drop back. He's got a chance. Save.
Look at how active the goaltender is, looking around the screen to try to make the stop.
Onside. He is hooked. He kind of shook it off and continues to play. There'll be a penalty. Sudbury's roster goes down by one here. At least briefly, a minor penalty for hooking.
More times than not, Doc, anytime you reach in around a player's hands that has the puck, you're going to get a hooking minor.
Every game presents a fork in the road opportunity, and this is it. It's a long 5-on-3 power play, and it begins now. Solid, clean win. And it's lifted back out of trouble.
7 minutes, 3 seconds.
Niagara's in their own end and in possession. Gets that pass back again. Pass attempt to Lemieux. Bad luck, broken stick. Oh, what a great keep. He's got possession. He's just got to get rid of it. Picks it up in his own end. Skate kick out of the scrum. The Ice Dogs in possession as they travel in their own end. In on the 2-on-2. Can they get reinforcements here? Passes to the slot. Fires. Did not find the net with the shot.
That's going to happen. There's not a lot of room there. He just missed the shot.
Sudbury's prevailed on another faceoff. Pass to the shooting position. Oh, what a break. That shot hit somebody. Held there for a faceoff coming up next. Niagara's got another win. The Wolves in their own end controlling the play. Still time on this power play, but not much. Terrific save there. Didn't look like he had anything to shoot at, and he made it tough.
Seems like he was in too tight on a goaltender.
Pitching it to Lemieux. A shot. Wow, what a glove save.
Well, the hands are quicker than a glove. Great save.
I don't know how the shooter can do much more than that. The goaltender made an excellent save on a great bid for goal.
The Ice Dogs win it. Oh, here's a wrister. He missed the net with the shot.
You have to give yourself a chance. That puck cannot miss the net like that.
The Wolves through the neutral zone, setting things up. It's a 3-on-2. How will they defend this? Wonderful job, though. Outmanned, a brilliant play. Not there. Niagara is setting things up at center. Lemieux tripped up. That should be a penalty. Sudbury's been assessed a minor penalty. 2 minutes, and the call is tripping.
I'm going to give credit to the puck carrier here. He kept his legs moving. He forced the back checker to reach in and take him off his feet.
There is hope with every man advantage, even if your percentage is poor. Are you listening? The Wolves with a clean win on the draw. They shot it back down. Now they can get ready for another rush. It is a hooking call on this play. A restraining foul, and the arm of the referee is hot. Using the point, he's got it. And we get a penalty here. The referee strides over to hand it out. Sudbury's two-minute penalty is a minor, and the call is hooking.
Well, what he was trying to do is try to get the puck, but unfortunately for him, he reached in and hooked around the player. Off to the penalty box he goes.
Every game presents a fork-in-the-road opportunity, and this is it. It's a long 5-on-3 power play, and it begins now. Off the faceoff, he ties his man up, and so the puck goes to his team. 44 seconds. The Ice Dogs have possession in their own end. Moving well with it between the blue lines. Strong play, good reach. Out in the slot, gets play stopped. A little under 8 minutes to be played in the second. It's a 1-0 game. The Ice Dogs paddled aside. Then he holds on. Strong play on that faceoff. You have to be strong to hold that other guy off. Niagara's going back further to get restarted on this man advantage. The Ice Dogs through the neutral zone controlling play now. Cut on by with that one. Fantastic shutdown. And that will help to at least clear the puck away. He's going to the net. Great opportunity, but the pass didn't connect. The Wolves carrying it in their own end. Play is stopped, and now we'll hear the call. Niagara's roster goes down by one here. At least briefly, a minor penalty for hooking.
This was okay about 10 years ago. Not anymore. That's a hooking call.
It is a short power play, but it's a 4-on-3, and it starts in the offensive zone.
Niagara penalty to number 10.
The draw, the tie-up, and his team prevails. The Ice Dogs' power play is over. They've had their problems tonight. He gets through. Outstanding save. Difficult opportunity.
Terrific stop from right in front of the net, but you got to find a way to put the puck in the net.
Nicely into the zone. Niagara's power play has ended. Not as good. Shoots. Save! Oh, it's very important if he can get that out. And the heat's taken off by the clear. Back in his defensive end to get it. And he's hammered.
I wonder if that hit will change the momentum of this game.
Hits one, and he missed the net.
He was trying to stick it right under the bar. He just missed it by a couple of inches, but he got all of that.
Propelled to Lemieux. The Ice Dogs are moving the puck in their own end. Really good move. He drives toward the slot.
And a good save in the goal crease. The Wolves in their own end have control of the puck.
Oh, he shook right through, didn't he? Good move. Jabbed away by Lemieux. Taken up the middle. Niagara's done it. Back at full strength. Taken away. The Wolves continue on in their own end. Between the blue lines. Good intercept. Now it's directed to Lemieux. Between the blue lines. That's a good solid poke check. Can he generate something from there? He's into the slot. Marvelous save. No time on that one.
A missed opportunity from this close in.
The Wolves with possession up the wing.
He slowed down a bit, and there'll be a hooking penalty called on this one. The Ice Dogs guilty of a minor penalty for using the stick blade. Just a hook. This has been a power play that's gotten a lot of times, but no, got it all.
That was all positioning, right into his glove.
Niagara's in their own end and has possession. Outstanding job taking the pressure off. Looks ahead to start something. Heads on to the corner. And he takes the heat off by clearing. The Ice Dogs look to make a difference up the wing. It's a 2-on-2. What'll they do next? On through the corner. In the slot, he's taken a perfect centering pass. Let's it go. Flattened with the hit. Players tired, about to get a rest, but still seconds to play in this period. Oh, and he is drilled.
Both teams have the same game plan. Be physical.
The Wolves carrying on in the defensive zone. Has gone back into his own end. Good job with the stick. Sudbury seeing the end of this period coming. Do they have time to start something and to finish it? The Wolves power play unit continues to be a bunch of oafers. That one is pointed to him. Niagara's in their own end setting things up. The second period has been played, and that's the fun part. We now look forward to the third.
Now's your chance to play clean. Join us in our arena as the first sports and entertainment facility in the entire country to use 100%.
The Wolves goaltender has not buckled yet. He's made some strong saves, but this one of the most recent big ones as we go to break.
Thank you for joining us in the campaign to save energy and keep our city clean.
We are entering the third period. Based on the first two, what are you expecting to happen?
Niagara's coaching staff, Doc, has to be pretty pleased the way they played through the first 40 minutes of play. One area of concern has been their offense. They need to take advantage of all the time of possession and finally put the puck into the back of the net.
With a drive. Oh, broke it up. Picks it up in his own end. The Wolves in their own end lug that puck along. Oh, and he's hammered.
I'm not sure if his coach wants him playing like that.
Forcing attention in deep. At the front of the net. Outstanding save. What magic even to get there and get the shot off.
The goalie makes himself look big.
The Ice Dogs have control of the puck in their own end. He's got that pass off the right wing and can move ahead. Pushing it on through the neutral zone. Brings a shot wide of the net. Oh, close call there.
Everything's got to go through the middle of the ice. That's exactly where he was, but he missed the chance.
Oh, a save there. Directing that one to Murphy. 2-on-1. Over. Shooting. Save. And he freezes for the whistle.
Well, that's a scoring chance gone for naught. That's an excellent save by the goaltender.
Beat him on that one. Gets that one on across. Great pad stop. Another save.
Amazing reflexes.
Picked up in the attacking zone. Receives that pass from the other side. Save! The Wolves shifting gears back in their own end. Shoots one. Got the pad on that one. And another save! Boom! What a great open ice hit. He's got that pass at the point.
And he regroups.
Right off the left wing, it comes on through right on his stick.
Snapping a pass to Lemieux. Moving along through the neutral zone.
Drives to the crease. Wonderful save. It didn't look like he had a thing to shoot at.
Not a lot of room to score from in that area. Great save.
The Wolves control the play through the neutral zone.
He takes that point pass. Didn't get through. Oh, look at this. Back in his defensive end to get it.
Trying to go to Lemieux.
Moves to the corner. Back in front, off the goalpost. Oh, he missed the net.
My dad once told me, Doc, if you don't hit the net, you can't score.
The Wolves have it in center ice.
Good defensive play.
Possession changes.
A hammer shot from the point. Loose, but he froze it. Stoppage of play.
Let's check in at ice level with Ray.
I've seen a lot of great goaltending performances. I don't know that I've seen many better than this. Let's take a look at some of his brilliance earlier this evening.
He has been spectacular in goal tonight. Absolutely, Ray. Thank you.
Just under 8 minutes to be played in the third. Sudbury's got the lead, 1-0. Nice faceoff work. Huge hit. Possession's gone.
Thought he had 10 feet of clean ice. He only had 5. There's the stop sign.
Hey, and there's another. Score! And the game is even.
The goalie made the initial stop, but those quick hands beat him on the rebound.
Well, that's a bang-bang play. Edzo quickly shot off the goaltender. He made the initial stop, but can't find the second one.
Niagara's tied the game here in the third period. Every shift will mean a lot now. The Ice Dogs win that neutral zone faceoff.
Assisted by number 10, Anthony Kuchinshia. Time of the goal.
Using the point.
58 seconds.
Let's go, Rister. And a save. Wonderful centering pass, and it's right to him. In front. Score! That's 2 unanswered goals.
How about that pass? He did not have a lot of time. He got it to the goal scorer and he put it in.
Really good positioning. He's in the butterfly where he's got most of the net covered, but there's obviously a hole in the pucks behind him.
Niagara's got the lead now by 1. Third period of play. It'll be a wonderful finish. Sudbury's got another face-off win. Point to point to point. Perfect connection right through center.
Time of the goal. 14 minutes.
And he regroups. He's got it on his stick. Perfect off that left wing. Can he generate something? Got that pass near the blue line and now looks ahead. Front of the net. They score. And they've tied the game up.
I love watching guys score on the back end.
Edzo, this has got to be a great shot because from my angle, there doesn't look like a lot of net. Even with the goaltender down, he seems to have most of it covered.
Just over 4 minutes remaining in the third. A hockey game is a game of lead changes. This one now is even. Sudbury's got that neutral zone faceoff.
The Wolves have it between the blue lines.
He's got that pass off the wing and can move ahead.
Keeps it going up the wing.
Knocked it away with the stick. Slides it to the point
to Murphy.
Missed. the net.
After he missed that chance, I looked over at the bench, and the look on the players' faces were priceless.
Chip to Lemieux. He could start some danger here. Keeps it going behind the goal.
Score! Back and forth they go.
He worked himself into a good scoring area and let it go on the backhand.
Oh, he can't get his pad down quick enough to make this stop. Really good shot, as you mentioned, Eddie. I think that's one he should probably stop.
The Ice Dogs have gotten a one-goal lead here in the third period. Do they go for two, or do they just try to protect this? They win the draw and will now set up an attack.
Jordan Milena, assisted by number 79 and by number 5, Blake Siebenhaar.
Looks ahead to start something.
17 minutes, 47 seconds.
The Wolves up the wing, lug the puck. Nearing the last minute of the third period.
Last minute of play in the third period.
Picks it up in his own end. Heads to the front.
Terrific save. Terrific opportunity.
You don't get many better opportunities than that. Great save.
And here's Ray.
Sudbury's got to get back on the practice ice because they've had so many chances to score. They haven't had any finish, and they can't hit the net.
Yeah, my Ray, it's sort of hard to watch those, isn't it? So many close calls, and this game would be different.
And they've won that draw. Picked up in the attacking zone. Side to side they go, trying to generate something. Back in his defensive end to get it. It's on his stick. What a brilliant pass that was. Wrist shot. Got a piece of that one. Great shooting position. The Wolves in possession as they travel through center ice.
Perfect pass, tape to tape. He's got it at center ice from right wing. Outstanding hitting in this game. There's an example.
Sometimes nowhere to go. We tried to squeeze through, guys, but he took a big hit.
Net open.
Dropped on back further. The puck is free, now taken up.
Net empty.
And the game is over. Sudbury's defeat was by a narrow score. Boy, on the shot board, they were overwhelmed.
Coaching staff cannot be happy with their defensive play.
Some nights are special in memory. This one was an outstanding game. So long for now.